Hello and welcome to the Fix-It Shed. If you like to save money by doing things yourself, you're going to want to subscribe and click the bell so you don't miss anything. So I have a can of WD-40 here, but you know, you can hear that there's still liquid in it, but when you go to spray, nothing comes out. So there's still quite a bit in here and I don't want to throw it away. So let's see if we can repressurize it so that we can use the rest of it. So first we just pull the spout off. This one's a little bit different as the spray nozzle has a tube that protrudes from the nozzle. So most of the other ones that I've seen, the tube protrudes from the can rather than the nozzle. So what I'm hoping with this one is that this is a one-way valve so that I can put air into it without having to press down. The air pressure itself will open up the valve and then it'll close so that the air pressure doesn't come back out. So we're gonna give that a try. So you may be wondering, how do I know how much air pressure to put in it? So I checked the material safety data sheet for the WD-40 and it says that the cans are pressurized to 95 to 115 PSI. So just to be safe, I'm just gonna set my compressor to 80 so that I don't risk over pressurizing the can. Okay, so that's around 120 PSI in the tank, so that's more than enough. So this is set at just right about 80 PSI, so I'm gonna work with that. Now, how do we connect the air hose to the can? Well, on the air hose, I'm just gonna use a regular tire chuck. And then for the can, I'm gonna use a valve stem. So I'm gonna take the cap off, and I'm also gonna take the core out of the valve stem. And it happens to just fit right over the hole on that metal top. And then I'm just gonna use the air chuck and I'm gonna pressurize. Okay. Let's see how that did. Too bad. Okay, so I've got usable can of WD-40 again. So it's maybe not the pressure that you would get a brand new can, but at least I can use it. So, and you know, I bought a pack of two of the valve stems at the auto parts store. I think they cost about $3 for the pack of two. So if you got something out of this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching. Take care.